Then, the beams of both these groups, whose places of existence were close to each other, often came into contact and had friendly relations, with the result that little by little each picked up from the other those specialties that had originally been invented by their ancestors. In short, the result of the frequent contacts between these two communities was that the Greek beings, borrowing from the Romans all their refinements of sexual turns, began organizing their what were called Athenian knights, while the Roman beings, having learned from the Greeks how to cook up sciences, composed their later very famous Roman law. A great deal of time has passed since then. The inventors of both those kinds of being manifestation have long since disappeared, and their descendants who chanced to become powerful have also disappeared. Yet now the contemporary three-brained beings of that planet fondly dedicate more than half their existence and the being energy they have acquired to absorbing and actualizing somehow or other, unconsciously and sometimes even consciously, those two ideals, whose initiators were the bored Asiatic fishermen and shepherds. Well then, my boy, later on it seems, when both these groupings of your favorites had acquired many of the aforementioned effective means for the successful destruction of the existence of beings like themselves, and had become past masters at persuading the beings of other beings